Before Star Wars Rise of the Skywalker came out last year, Disney released a flickering light warning that the special effects could affect those who are photosensitive. As I pointed out in my video, Disney had that problem with The Incredibles 2 in 2018. When I saw that movie in IMAX on opening weekend, I felt a stabbing pain in my eyeballs from the strobing light effects. Printed warnings went up at the box office and the theater doors shortly thereafter. When I saw the movie again in digital a month later, a warning appeared before the movie, and strobing light effects gave me a headache. Although Disney partially fits the problem for the Blu-ray release, the flickering lights were still a problem on any device with an HDR screen. What about Rise of the Skywalker? I've seen the movie in digital, Dolby, and IMAX in December and January, and I recently watched it on iTunes after getting a new video card that supported HDR on my HDR-capable monitor. In this video, I'm going to review how bad the flickering lights were in each theater format and iTunes with HDR for Windows 10 enabled. If you're interested in getting a copy of Star Wars Rise of the Skywalker, an Amazon affiliate link can be found in the description below. My channel gets a small commission from each sale. Your support is greatly appreciated. The first time I saw Rise of the Skywalker was in digital on opening day at the Punyard Cinema in Campbell. I got a headache from the flickering lights, the fast pacing of the storyline, and two movies crammed into one to make up for the mistake that was The Last Jedi. Like The Incredibles 2 in digital, I got a headache from the flickering lights. Rise of the Skywalker has a load of flickering lights. The only saving grace of watching at a dine-in theater was a Tatooine sandwich with pulled pork, ham, and Swiss cheese on toasted bread that tasted great. The second time I saw Rise of the Skywalker was in Dolby at Eastridge Mall on New Year's Day. I didn't get a headache from the flickering lights, the fast pacing of the storyline, and the two movies crammed in to one to make up for the mistake that was The Last Jedi. Dolby was a much better experience than digital. The only saving grace of watching in Dolby was the more comfortable recliner seats. The third time I saw Rise of Skywalker was in IMAX at the Metreon in San Francisco. My friend and I took Bart from the Fremont Station and walked 4 blocks from the Market Station to the Metreon at 4th and Mission. We didn't see any piles of human poop on the sidewalk, but I almost stepped into a pile of dog poop. The Metreon IMAX screen is the second largest IMAX screen in the U.S. at 75 feet tall and 97 feet wide. I didn't get a headache from the flickering lights, fast pacing of the storyline, and the two movies crammed in to one to pretend that The Last Jedi never existed. IMAX, especially at the Metreon, was the best viewing experience out of the three formats. Last month, I got a new MSI RX 570 8GB video card to replace my 3-year-old Gigabyte NVIDIA 1050 Ti 4GB video card. One of the new features of the MSI video card was HDR via HDMI. My 27-inch monitor, Pixel PX276H, also supports HDR via HDMI. Unfortunately, HDR on Windows 10 is a hot mess and not worth the effort. I briefly watched Rise of the Skywalker on my PC with HDR enabled and got the same eyeball stabbing pain that I experienced with The Incredibles 2 on IMAX. I switched the monitor back over to the DisplayPort on the video card and got the same viewing experience I had from watching Rise of the Skywalker on IMAX at the Metreon. My viewing experience of Rise of the Skywalker from worst to best followed the same order at the format that I saw in the theaters. Digital gave me a headache. Dolby was better than digital. IMAX, especially at the Metron, was great. As for iTunes on the PC, watching with HDR on Windows 10 was terrible, but watching on the DisplayPort was great. A friend told me that he got a warning message about flickering lights when he watched Rise of the Skywalker on his HDR-enabled iPhone. You might want to avoid HDR on any HDR-enabled devices or Windows 10. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and click on the notification bell to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching.